Hi friends, today we are going to see a topic called as TCP Congestion Control Algorithms. So this congestion control TCP protocol handles in a different way. Actually, this topic is not on explaining what is congestion control algorithm, rather than I am going to explain you through network simulator too. So after this initial talk, you can able to see the simulation of TCP congestion control. So we can compare various TCP versions of various protocols and how their congestion handled in a wired environment. So you can able to use wireless as well as can use able to use wired networks, but we are going to consider on a wired network. So I am going to use it on ns2. So this experiment is mainly for the undergraduate students, those who are trying to learn what is congestion control. Actually, congestion control works in three phases. So number one is slow start, number two is congestion avoidance, number three is congestion detection. So slow start, during slow start, the number of segments transmitted from the source to the destination will be, the sender to the receiver will be exponentially increasing. So exponentially means initially starting with 1, 2, 4, 8, like that. So the exponential means not necessarily be in powers of 2, it could be exponential increase. So once it is reaches to a SS threshold, so there is a thing called a slow start threshold. Once it reaches the threshold, the segments getting added one by one. So suppose the segment is I, that means next thing i+1 i+2 i+3 i+4, like that it will be keep on adding till it reaches the congestion detection. So first thing is slow start threshold. After the slow start threshold, it will go to the second thing called as congestion avoidance. Then later it will go for congestion detection. So congestion detection TCP handles in two different ways. So heavier congestion detection and lighter congestion detection. Heavier congestion detection is if some segments have been sent and it didn't hear anything from the receiver, then TCP handles in a stringent way, that is a congestion, a stronger congestion detection. So in that case, what happens? The congestion comes back again to the slow start threshold. So that means again it starts from the slow start threshold. In the second lighter congestion, so TCP that also handles it based on three duplicate acknowledgements. After it receives three duplicate acknowledgements, it can understand that there is a slow start congestion, there is a lighter congestion. So in that case, it will go to the congestion avoidance state. So first thing is slow start threshold, congestion avoidance and congestion detection. So during congestion detection, there will be two stages. Either the stage should come back to slow start threshold, or it has to go to the congestion avoidance. For a stronger congestion, it come back to slow start threshold. For a lighter congestion, it goes to the congestion avoidance phase. So that's how it works. So you read the books for more information about congestion control, like fast rate transmission, what is the three duplicate acknowledgement. So all these things you can able to read from a book. But now we will go to ns2 on these three parameters: rwnd, cwnd, swnd, ss thresh. These are the four variables that we will be having it in TCP. rwnd means receiver window, swnd will mean sender window, cwnd means congestion window, and ss thresh means slow start threshold. So these are the four variables which are been handled in most of the network simulations. In ns2 also we handle it: ss thresh underscore, cwnd underscore, rwnd underscore, and swnd underscore. So using these four variables, how the congestion window will be printed. So what we do is, in the x-axis we can print the number of timing, in the y-axis we can print the congestion window value. So in that case, we can able to see the congestion happens this way. So it will go from exponential increase, then additive increase, then after it detects, it may come back there. Either it can come back to the slow start where it meets at the same line, or it can come back in between and again it will start from there. So that's how the three phases of congestion works. So let's see how this will be happening in a simulator. Thank you.